when I came to MIT as an undergrad, I loved music, I played tons of music, and I was an engineering major. So these two were awesome, wonderful things that I loved to do, but they were separate, meaning I took my engineering classes over here, I played music over here, and the two didn't really interact. Until I got to grad school at MIT, and I was at the Media Lab, and working with Todd Macover, and that's really where I saw, oh, you can have engineering and music be combined together into one thing. One of the classes I took when I was at MIT as a grad student was a signal processing class. So when I say signal processing, or sometimes signal analysis, one way to think about that is, you know those meters where they kind of tell you how loud something is? That is signal processing. And this thing clicked with me, which was, oh, wait a minute, music is sound. And so the signal processing thing that I'm learning about, even though it might be kind of abstract, I see how it ties directly into music. I was able to see how someone who plays music, you know, can make these beautiful sounds, but then how signal processing can analyze what's going on with the sound and maybe tell you some things about what's going on with the sound. When I graduated from MIT with a master's, and I got to know my good friend Alex Rigopoulos, the two of us decided to start this company together, Harmonix. And the idea behind Harmonix was to let everyone in the world experience the joy of making music. That's what we were trying to do. We didn't know how we were going to do that. We had a bunch of ideas. Most of them didn't work. And in fact, it took 10 years between when we started the company and when our game Guitar Hero came out. It was a long road, but ultimately very gratifying to see that the thing that we were trying to do in the very beginning, which was give people that magical feeling of what it's like to play music, we were able to finally do that with this video game. After about 20 years, maybe I was starting to look for something else. And that's also the time that I got a call from an old professor of mine at MIT, a music professor. And he said, hey, Eran, would you like to come teach a class at MIT? And so the idea of being able to come back to MIT, to my roots almost, was really attractive. And I thought, maybe there's something I could offer. Maybe there's something I can give back or contribute back to MIT, because it did so much for me. We are now launching a new program at MIT, a graduate program in music technology and computation. The program is really about creating this space for students to learn about how to combine their music passion and their engineering and technology passion in one discipline. One of the things we hope happens when students engage in this music technology graduate program with us is that they gain skills in two different ways. One is specifically about how do you marry music and technology together, and how do you create interesting new experiences for people.